Unlike traditional venture capital funds that might raise at most a few billions from wealthy families and pension funds, SoftBank needed to raise much, much more because its strategy is different. When those traditional venture capital firms are confronted with a bizarre failed investments, more often than not, they will shrug it off, pointing out that their overall returns are overwhelmingly generated from a few hugely successful bets. This model is most effective with software companies, which require some startup capital to hire engineers and start selling a product, and then can quickly turn into a highly profitable business as they find a market and mature. But as the technology industry grew, the market for funding tech companies changed. The following financial crisis, interest rates fell to rock bottom level. Cash piled up on companies' balance sheets and in the hands of ultra wealthy, and regulatory changes make going public quickly less attractive. Technology companies were able to raise hundreds of millions of dollars from mutual funds, sovereigns, wealthy funds, and other huge pools of capital when 10 years earlier they would have had to sell the shares of the public. The resources and eagerness to be part of these funds and the wealthy families that spent lots of money on it would come to mean what one might call overinvestment. While the cost of a traditional startup has plumped into cheaply available server across Amazon, companies that in the balance of the industry move atom stuff instead of bits can be ruinously expensive to run. Whether it's the cost of leasing and building new location for WeWork, or the torrents of the rider discount of driver bonuses that Uber and Lyft pay out to start up new market, these companies eat through investor cash for years in order to survive. Looking backward through the telescope, the mega funding for app-based taxi cab, like Uber and Lyft, beer distributing office subleases made more sense as a case of savvy operators creating landing zone for massive flows of cash or demands for big tech investment, creating a supply of them which can then be sold as the next new big thing. What distinguishes many of these companies, especially one of the received investment from SoftBank, is that neither fish nor fowl. Real world software nature along with the need for capital. As popular business analyst Ben Thompson has argued, the vision funds may have confused company that lots of capital with companies that offer big opportunities, resulting in a paucity of tech companies in its portfolio, and instead a collection of WAX and WeWork. So why did the Saudi government want to pour money into companies selected seemingly almost at random by a charismatic and eccentric Japanese businessman? The resulting fit between the Saudis and Newman was not just awkward for business reason, but also cultural. Not because Newman is Israeli, a Jew, or like weed and tequila, but because to a degree unusual even by a startup founder standards, WeWork had wrapped itself in gauzy rhetoric about the ability to change the world. This led to predictable tension when it turned out to the company's biggest founder, Saudi Arabia, a country ruled by a foreign regime and where religious authorities still exercise tremendous control over everyday life. But as it is so often the case in the world of technology investment, what looked like a contradiction may actually be consistency. If WeWork couldn't offer software as return of investment, then it could Of all the sub If WeWork couldn't offer software as return of investment, then it could offer the superficial trapping of a technology company, spiritual populism about elevating global consciousness, and a charismatic CEO with a fondness for giving talks with microphone attached to his face, and an overall approach sometimes appeared to have started with the HBO satire Silicon Valley and then worked backward into an actual company. If Saudi Arabia wanted to more fully immerse itself into the global economy, then it had to sign on for a pseudo new age bullshit on offer from some of its largest companies. For the companies whose social liberalism often runs far ahead of Republican parties, let alone the House of Soft. SoftBank's intermediate role offered plausible, deniable, but as Mohammed bin Salman put it himself, with an admirable directness, without the PIF, Saudi Arabia's sovereign wealth fund, there will be no SoftBank Vision Fund. In the old days, which is to say before 2017, Saudi leaders were content in their relationship with the US to relatively discreet. Ever the flashy millennial, bin Salman wanted the attention, touring the US in 2018 and publicly warring the most visible institutions of the American Imperium. Technology executive, prominent journalist Dwayne Rock Johnson, as part of the much balanced opening of Saudi Arabia. He even allowed an American movie to be screened on Saudi soil. The film told the story of a young king seeking to open his rich but isolated country to the world, Black Panther. The attempted diversification of Saudi Arabia's economy has occasionally veered into a farce, like when the government tasked Western consulting firm and implemented bin Salman's dream of a future city in Abu Dhabi. The we in WeWork was the customers working in the office, living in the apartment buildings, and learning in the schools, not the people determined where any of this was built, and in what quantity. If money is indeed piling up in the balance sheet of a large corporation in its coffers of Saudi treasury as proceeds for burning the planet, and if the money is ultimately the disposal of a farthing Japanese mobile phone module, one might ask if could one manage differently if there were hands-off well done.